Hello, and welcome to the second video of our regression analysis tutorial series. For the first video, click the annotation, or the link in the description box. In this tutorial, we'll continue the analysis discussion we started earlier, and use an advanced technique called stepwise regression to help us find an optimal set of explanatory variables for this model. We'll use the same sample data we used in the first video. It has been gathered from 20 different salespeople. Weekly sales is the dependent variable, and two explanatory variables are intelligence and extroversion. Like before, take time to note how we organize our input data. Values for each variable are placed in separate columns, and each observation, or salesman, is represented by a separate row. Next, we introduce the mask. The mask is a Boolean array that chooses which variable is included or excluded from the analysis. At the top of the table, let's insert the mask cells array, each with a value of 1. In this example, we have 20 observations and 2 independent or explanatory variables. The response or dependent variable is the weekly sales. Let's begin. Select an empty cell in your worksheet where the output is going to be generated and click on the regression icon on the Nomic Cell tab. The regression wizard pops up. By default, the output cells range is set to the current selected cell in your worksheet. Like we've said before, the selected cells range can include the column headings, which would be used in the output tables. And because explanatory variables are already grouped by columns, we don't need to change anything. Now, select the cells range for the response-dependent variable values, or the weekly sales. Then select the cells range for the explanatory or independent variables. For the mask variables, select the cells of the Boolean array at the top of the data table. Once all of the data is selected, the other tabs in the wizard become enabled. Let's check out the Options tab. The tab is set to the default values you see here. Similar to the first tutorial, we won't change anything. The regression intercept constant, which, like we've said in our first video, indicates that the regression intercept will be estimated by the regression, is left blank. If you want to set the regression to a fixed value, enter it there. The significance level is set to 5%. In the output section, the most common regression analysis is selected. Lastly, the auto-modeling option should be left unchecked. We'll discuss it in a later video. Now, let's see the missing values tab. Here you can select how you want to handle missing values in your data. By default, any missing value found in X or in Y observations will be excluded from the analysis. This treatment is still a good approach for our purposes, so let's leave it unchanged. Now click OK to generate the output tables. Let's examine the results. Aside from the mask variable setting, everything else that we've done up to this point is the same as in our first tutorial. The mask setting determines which variable is included in the regression analysis. So let's take another look at the coefficients table. First, let's exclude the intelligence input variable from the analysis. This is done simply by flipping the mask value of the cell to 0. Then, if you have the calculation option set to manual, you can force recalculation. Otherwise, the spreadsheet recalculates automatically. As we look at the output tables again, we can see that there has been some changes. The R-squared dropped by 6%, while the adjusted R-squared dropped by 1.5. The standard error increased by $3, and AIC dropped by 1. ANOVA table shows the regression is significant. Residual diagnosis checks out for all tests. Lastly, in the regression coefficients table, the intercept and the coefficient of the extroversion variable are both statistically significant. You can see that despite having only one parameter, the recalculated model explains the variation in the values of the response variable just as well as the one that had access to two variables. Now, let's plot the estimated values against the actual. The shaded area represents the 95% confidence interval for the estimates of the regression model. Let's recap. So far, we've shown that dropping a variable from the analysis is as easy with Nomic Cell as flipping a switch. This feature allows you to avoid cluttering your spreadsheets with tons of output tables. But you might be wondering, what if I have more than two explanatory variables? Then what's the optimal number to use? NumExcel can help. The software supports stepwise regression function that helps you select the optimal set of variables. Let's see how it works. First, in the mask cells range, turn the variables on or off that you wish the stepwise regression to consider. For this demonstration, we will turn them all on. Now click on the regression icon in NumExcel tab. The regression wizard pops up. In the general tab, select the input cells range and the mask cells range. Under the options tab, check the stepwise regression box. Leave the other three different methods checked. Now click OK. The stepwise regression generates one additional table next to the coefficients. Let's take a closer look. The table shows the results of a series of tests that determine whether to include or drop a certain variable from the regression model. Forward selection is a method that starts with considering one intercept and examines adding an additional variable. Backward elimination starts from the full model and considers dropping one repressor at a time. Bidirectional elimination is a hybrid of the two methods. The table displays the mask for the optimal model found in each column. 1 stands for inclusion and 0 for exclusion. At the bottom, we compare the regression statistics for each model. In this case, the three models came back with the same set of variables. So far, we have created a regression model, examined its significance, verified that it satisfies underlying assumptions, and found the optimal subset of variables of the model. Join us in our third video on regression, where we'll discuss the model even further. That is it for now. Thank you for watching.